Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. We start with the weather, of course. Snow, sleet, and rain, and everything in between hitting New Hampshire today and overnight. Snow started early, as you can see in Littleton. A big mess is headed our way for later today. We already have dozens of school notices, and you can find those here on our website. Residents in more than 100 communities cast ballots for town meeting day yesterday. Schools topped the list in many towns. In Newmarket, voters rejected building a new $45 billion middle and high school. Pelham is getting a new school, and residents in Hooksett decided against sending their high school students to Pinkerton Academy in Derry. You can find a full list of the results. We continue to get them in here on our website. Republican Joe Kenney of Wakefield is claiming victory this morning in the race to fill Ray Burton's seat on the executive council, but the race is still too close to call, and Democrats have not conceded. Right now, Kenney leads Democrat Michael Cryans by about 1,000 votes, but nearly three dozen small towns have not reported yet, and the Secretary of State's office says official results won't be available until at least this afternoon. District 1 covers more than 100 communities across the northern half of the state and about 264,000 people. Creepy Uncle Jim. That's what some employees began calling suspended Rockingham County Attorney Jim Reams for his alleged treatment of women in his office. On Tuesday, the Attorney General's office released the results of its four-month-long investigation into Reams without filing any criminal charges. The AG's office is seeking to remove Reams from office based on his alleged conduct. It alleges that Reams abused his office by manipulating a forfeiture account using funds in a manner it describes as unethical but not illegal. The first sexual harassment claims against Reams surfaced 15 years ago, and the complaint describes more than a dozen allegations by female employees through the last decade.
County Attorney Reams denies that he ever inappropriately touched or said anything to anyone. He looks forward to actually discovering the basis for these allegations.
The AG's office says Reams took punitive action against women who complained about his alleged behavior, demoted or marginalized women who became pregnant, and made sexually charged or inappropriate comments. Well, a little girl from Salem is going through cancer treatment, and yesterday she got a very special gift thanks to some local high school students. Ava London received a wig made from real hair and small enough for a five-year-old. In January, she was diagnosed with a brain tumor and had emergency surgery to remove it. Hundreds of students at Londonderry High School donated their hair during the school's day of giving, and with some help from the Pantene Beautiful Lengths program, delivered the wig last night.
This is like the other end of the rainbow. The first end is all the students donating and pledging, not knowing who's going to receive their hair, but they give so willingly and they do so much for that. And we come all the way sort of to the other end where now we're able to take the wigs that people have made and now contribute them and give them to someone who needs them.
Ava's wig still needs to be trimmed a bit and styled to better frame her face, but the hope is she can wear it to kindergarten when she goes back to class and cheerleading. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.